We long to create, to explore, to leave our mark. Not out of ego, but out of the desire to contribute to humanity, to push us forward. We want to rediscover wonder. In the past 25 years, 250 million people in China were lifted out of poverty. 250 million people entered the global conversation, providing new ideas, new tools. What if the piano wasn't created in time for Mozart? Every invention, every course-altering creation came from the decision to act. We can have all the ideas we want, but they're nothing without taking action. One interesting example is how Frank and Swift were able to write the code and the algorithms necessary for an unmanned helicopter to fly a predetermined path using GPS satellites and waypoints in space. So they literally sat back to back, lived in the same apartment, and just coded all day. They would only sleep when the software needed to run, you know, simulations for 4 or 5 hours at a time so they could try to suss out the bugs. So they would, you know, sleep for 4 hours, or they would go grab a bite to eat while it was running its simulations, and then inevitably it would hit some bug, and then, you know, Frank would have a hard time figuring out where this bug come from. So Swift would actually write a debugging program to go in and try to find where the bug was. So then they would figure out the bug, and then Frank could then fix it in the algorithms and, you know, get to the next step. So they literally fed off of each other for a month, just eating and sleeping, not knowing what time it was. Okay, it's done debugging, it's 2 a.m. We wake up, we work for another 4 or 5 hours so we can get it to go into its next simulation process. And I think it's that spirit, you know, that you know, the founders brought to this company. That's the reason why anytime you go into a lab at DJI, no matter what hour of the day, there's gonna be some engineer in there at 3 a.m. or 5 a.m. or 6 p.m. or 8 p.m. or 2 p.m. You know, at any time during the day, there's people in there cranking. And it's because they're inspired by the leaders of the company. It's pretty cool. Technology is creativity and, you know, finding a creative way to solve a problem. We want to use technology to be able to break down the barriers between what we see in our mind and what we're able to manifest into the world and create for other people to see. You know, people have literally been talking about that for 15 years, to get some kind of stabilized system that would fly on a remote control helicopter and, you know, provide stable footage. I was fortunate enough to meet up with Frank and Swift. You know, I saw the algorithms, the stability algorithms that they had for the ACE-1 autopilot system for helicopters, and how it would respond one-to-one with the IMU that was on the helicopter. Luckily, we were talking one day about, hey, do you think you guys could make a system using a similar algorithm that would give us a really, really stable platform to put a camera on that we could actually get some amazing shots with? And luckily, they're the kind of people that act, that do, and they made it happen. At the end of each challenge, we'd ask ourselves, what now? What would be fun to work on next? What would stretch our imaginations? What tool could we create that would unleash future minds and imaginations?
The Phantom specifically was so exciting to me because I finally saw a product that was as versatile as a GoPro. I think it's allowing a lot of people to come into the filmmaking scene and make noise, because they're able to make really high quality products with kind of minimal amounts of gear. The especially right here in my hometown of Mount Shasta, there's just so many falls that I've run, you know, multiple times, but I've never been able to capture aerial content. You can pop your GoPro on your Phantom and you can capture content that before now just really hasn't been accessible. And so you have to be very selective of what you're bringing on the water. GoPro, obviously, you know, it gives you that kind of in-seat perspective, the POV. You can mount it to almost anything, but having a UAV device that fits in your kayak it's never been done before. It just provides kind of a world of options in terms of getting out there and really putting what you see in your mind on screen. Without those tools, I don't believe I could tell my story in the same way. I think that all these kind of crazy dreams that I've had, you know, over the last decade of kind of being in the whitewater industry is finally going to have a platform that I can kind of launch those ideas from. It takes you from being a dreamer and kind of imagining all this stuff to kind of putting the tools in your hands that you can actually go out and create.
We want these tools to be an immediate, real-time extension of your mind's eye or your imagination.
The more that I kind of invest energy towards whatever I'm seeing in my mind, the more consistently I'm seeing it come to fruition.
We as humanity, as people, are always searching, longing to move forward for some new horizon, bolder vision, larger vistas, to push ourselves, to push humanity, to expand our universe, to look at it anew and rediscover wonder. Years ago, a $60 million supercomputer took up half a building. Now, it fits in the palm of your hand, and it's 1,000 times more powerful. That's a billion-fold improvement in price, performance, and miniaturization. Imagine where the UAV industry will be in 5 to 10 years. Imagine the stories we'll be able to tell, and the shots we'll be getting.